could you guys just share maybe a highlight of your homeschool experience, or maybe even your challenge experience?
Sharing that.
I really liked, I started the challenge program in challenge two and went along with where I am now. I have two of my classmates in here. Hi, Grace, Nika. Just want to say hi to them real quick. I really enjoyed the friends that I met along the way through it, through a lot of things that happened in my life. Just meeting the people there and like going through with all like the duo interpretations, especially in challenge four, were very interesting to do with your classmates, because it was funny seeing who you were paired up with and how the two or three of you would like end up messing around with what you were doing and what the end product was. So to me, the friendship and stuff in challenge throughout the years that I had done it was very important to me, especially with what I went through, like just stuff I went through and stuff. So like I said,
that's awesome. Thank you for sharing that.
I never really liked like public speaking and stuff, but I feel like I came into challenge when I was a junior, and I started with challenge two, and then I just finished challenge three as a senior. And it was really cool because my mom got to be my tutor. I really liked the like how they like prepared you for like debate and like speech and stuff, because it like really helped me work on my presenting skills, which I definitely needed, like not like definitely needed help on, but like I was like nervous and stuff like that whenever I would like speak in front of people. So it made me like feel more confident. And I really liked working with like different classmates and stuff like that on like debate and stuff. And yeah, it just really helped my public speaking.
That's awesome, Amanda. So it sounds like both you know, Brenna and you, Amanda, came in the challenge years. Okay. And you, Amanda, did you come in from like public school or private school, or where'd you come in from?
I've been homeschooled my whole life.
How was that transition? Was it like, did you dig challenge coming from, you know, a non-CC background? Or?
Yeah, I really enjoyed it because it was like, I had a class, but we were still like homeschooling and I was still able to like stay home and like kind of like do my own thing. I guess I'm a very independent person. I like to make up my own schedules and stuff. So it was really nice that we could like have, like I could have a class as well as still being homeschooled. And I had like friends alongside me, and like if I had a problem, like for instance, one of my friends, he's like really good in like science and stuff. So whenever I didn't understand something, I'd be like, hey, could you understand, or could you explain this for me? And he would like explain it and I'd be like, oh, I understand it now. And it was just like really nice and stuff to have that.
That's great. Love it. That's
if there's
great.
Anything that really stuck out to me in CC, it's always the community. CC is kind of a very unique homeschool, and certainly more unique than many public schools, in that you're not just fed this knowledge. You get to go through it yourself, and you get to talk about it with other people. If there's anything that CC definitely helped me out with, it was keeping me out of my own world, because I, you know, keep to myself, and, you know, I am actually pretty good at being outgoing, but it's just one of those issues that I got. If anything, I really enjoy the Socratic discussions, whether we're talking about actual philosophy or we're going over the different types of discoveries from discoverers. It's just amazing how you could go over all these kind of things. Also, I love going over the classics, so CC just, it was amazing.
The friendships that I cultivated through Challenge and through CC, they're just real unique. You know, we've made friendships outside of class, but the ones that, you know, are sticking with us are the ones that we've made through community. And just the study skills that it taught me were real valuable. It just taught us how to study, how to keep ourselves accountable. It taught me, you know, independence in my homework. By the time I was in, you know, challenge one or two, I was already teaching myself the majority of what I was learning. And, you know, I think someone else mentioned public speaking is, you know, I discovered a passion for public speaking. And just, you know, it kind of cultivates your strengths, you know what I mean? Just in conversations and your friendships. And I felt stronger.
So I just want to say, I just love how CC really relates everything back to the Bible. And, you know, whether you're talking about ancient literature or philosophy, like everything, I just love how the conversations were so wrapped up in how does this relate back to the truth? And as I'm like about to head off to a secular school, I think Challenge 4 was just great. Just working in, I mean, I loved theology, just getting to study, spend the whole first semester studying the Old Testament. And then with Robbie Zacharias, I think it's just been awesome. Realizing that like everything, especially like in our relativism today, I think Challenge 4 really connected everything back to just how do we seek truth in this world. So yeah, I definitely loved how everything just connects right back to scripture. And that's really, I think the biggest thing I've learned is that, you know, you can find truth even in ancient literature where like everything's so messed up, or in, I don't know how to say it, Oedipus Rex. I think that's my favorite thing.
Yeah, I've always loved literature and reading. So it was great. All of the literature throughout all of the years of Challenge, I did B through 4, but all of the literature, it was great opportunity to read things that I wouldn't have read prior to this, just things that would never have come across. Yeah, the literature was probably my favorite, but I loved all the discussions as well. It was just a great experience.
In the middle of my high school year, I moved. So in Challenge 2, I moved. So I went from a group that I started out with in sixth grade, then I moved in the middle of my junior year. So it was very difficult, but also CC made it very, very easy for that because the groups were so opening and so just accepting to anyone new coming in because they've grown up knowing how to start a conversation with anybody. And I think that is the overall thing that I loved about CC, that it just helps you communicate better one-on-one with people and not just through a screen or through messaging or anything like that. Another thing that really grew on me, like everyone else has said, is the public speaking area. I definitely have grown in that area so much that the Lord has decided to use that through me and is sending me off to college for a Bible communications degree. And I am super excited to see what the Lord has for that. And yeah, that's what I like about CC.
So I wouldn't be necessarily described as being super educationally gifted, but CC allowed some flexibility. So if I have a question, I can ask my tutor, I can ask my mom. And if I was in public school, I'd have, let's say, a similar question. They'd just be like, nah, you good. Because there's 30 mouths to feed in the class instead of like 4 or a one-on-one situation with my mom. So that ability really helped me to like level the playing field, I guess you would say, in that sense. So then I could rise to be around that same level. So that really helped me a lot.
Excellent perspective, Chase. I love that. I love that, dude.
One thing I really liked about CC, and this is something that I tell people when they, you know, ask me what I think about it, is that it teaches you how to think, not what to think, because there are a lot of programs that kind of, like, they almost indoctrinate you into, like, this is what you need to think and this is why, but CC doesn't do that. It says, these are the tools that you need in order to think. Now use these tools and go out and like find a way to think. So that's what I always tell like parents who ask me, like, what do you think of CC? That's always the first thing I tell them. It teaches you what, like how to think, not what to think.
For me, the biggest thing was with CC, I hated it growing into it. Like, my family had been homeschooling since homeschooling was a thing and since it was shunned on. But so like growing up, I was under a rock homeschool, I'll put it that way, where it's literally we sat in the kitchen doing school from about 7 to say 2-3 o'clock, and then we'd be free to go play outside the rest of the day. Well, I should have been in Challenge B, but in Challenge A, I joined and it was a completely new experience. I had a hard time at that time talking to even my family, let alone strangers. And so to be dumped inside of a classroom full of a bunch of people, I had no idea who they were. And it was like, what am I supposed to do? So for that, for me, it was a whole new experience, and I love being able to grow through that, because even in Challenge A, I had the hardest time writing. Like, for me, that was a real struggle, and in Challenge A, I had the hardest time even writing a one-paragraph essay on an animal or a plant. That, for me, was phenomenal that I could even get that done. But then realizing by the time I got to even Challenge B and doing mock trial, and it was, we just went through a 2,000-word essay on why this person's guilty. And then getting to Challenge 4 and writing a senior thesis of 12 pages, whereas back in Challenge A, I would have had a hard time writing 12 sentences. And so it's phenomenal to me that the work that CC and the peer group can do to you. And also one of the biggest things, like Sabrina was talking about, CC doesn't teach you how to think, they or teach you what to think, they teach you how to think. That's the biggest thing for me, because I didn't know how to think. But with logic and all the other things, that's been one of the biggest growths for me, both spiritually and physically and mentally, is going through CC and through each one learning something new. And I would say for me, my favorite one would have been poetry in Challenge 3. I grew more in that strand than all of the previous strands before. Like, that was where God spoke the most to me. And it's amazing to see how much you can grow in something that seems so small.